Alrighty, Emma, thank you very much. Happy Monday, your first weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices. With locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. Alright, let's get into things this morning. Not too bad as we do move forward. There are a few showers that are developing, even a few rumbles of thunder that have been developing earlier this morning as well. We do have a few showers that will be common as well, and a few rumbles of thunder, mainly during the morning period. As for the afternoon, we will be under a partly cloudy sky overall. As we do zoom things out and give you the bigger picture, just some clouds that are currently moving through, along with a few showers and a rumble of thunder as well. Again, this afternoon, a lot of this will start to taper off as some sunshine will start to peek out. Future cast for today reflecting now the partly cloudy sky for us today. More clouds later on tonight. But after midnight, the clouds get out of here. We'll have a lot of sunshine to start things off for you Tuesday. The winds won't be a huge deal, though. They'll be switching around a bit, but only at around 5 to 10 miles per hour overall. They'll be a little bit more on the gusty side tomorrow with sustained winds at around 10 miles per hour or more. Gusty winds up to 20 miles per hour cannot be ruled out either. So as for today, upper 70s, maybe some lower 80s if you're lucky. Some morning showers and a rumble of thunder. Partly cloudy with that north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. That partly cloudy sky will be during the afternoon period. Middle 50s for tonight with a partly cloudy sky. That north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Our only forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period showing a mostly cloudy sky with a few morning showers possible. Temperatures in the 70s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up. Emma?
Thank you, Devin. Sorry about that, folks. I had an issue with my microphone. Okay, let's dive into it now. Today on Good Morning Maine, billowing smoke from a structure fire in Clifton was visible from the airline road over the weekend. Plus, COVID cases are back on the rise here in Maine and nationwide. And we'll hear about affordable housing advocates. We'll hear from affordable housing advocates regarding the plot of land in Bradford that may be used as a remedy to the homelessness crisis. Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith and thank you for joining us on this cloudy Monday morning. We already got a check of that forecast with Devin Biggs, so let's just dive right into it this morning. All right, first off the bat, a man was found dead early Saturday morning after his vehicle flipped over. Upon arrival, troopers learned the driver of the vehicle, 51-year-old John Emerson of Franklin, was deceased. According to a press release from the Maine State Police spokesperson, Shannon Moss, around 1:08 a.m., the Bangor Regional Communications Center received a report that the crash occurred on 45 West Franklin Road in Franklin. A passing motorist reportedly located a 2010 silver Chevy Aveo upside down on the opposite side of the roadway. The initial investigation indicates that Emerson had crossed the center line prior to leaving the roadway and striking a large rock, which resulted in his vehicle overturning. Speed is believed to be a contributing factor in that crash. In other news, also on Saturday, firefighters quickly put out a structure fire in Clifton. The Eddington Fire Department responded to reports of an unknown fire on the airline road in Clifton around noon. Responding units found a small structure containing lawn equipment engulfed in flames.
Dispatch received multiple calls from multiple different locations that there was a fairly decent sized fire back in the woods somewhere. And it was a garage type structure that was fully involved.
The structure has been deemed a total loss and one person received minor injuries. Units from Holden and Dedham were also on scene. The fire marshal's office is currently investigating the cause of the fire. COVID-19 cases are back on the rise in Maine. Asia Reed looks at how one school district is approaching COVID this school year and what Maine doctors are saying about the new strain in the state.
With days already getting cooler and school right around the corner, the Maine CDC says Mainers need to start thinking about preparing for the fall virus season in a new COVID strand.
The optimism in me says that we're not going to have it impact schools heavily. That said, you know, COVID hasn't gone away. I don't anticipate it will.
Lewiston Superintendent Jake Langless says his district is working to keep up with the latest CDC COVID guidelines. Health experts say there is a gradual uptick in COVID right now in Maine, thanks to COVID's new strain, EG5.
It doesn't seem to be more serious so far than prior strains, though it may be a bit more contagious.
Maine Health Chief Improvement Officer Dr. Dora Ann Mills says the recent increase in cases is not alarming. She also says there's an updated vaccine rolling out in just a few weeks. A spokesperson for the Maine Department of Health and Human Services tells CBS 13 News in a statement, quote, "The updated COVID vaccine will be targeted to better protect against infection, severe illness, hospitalization, and death from these latest strains of the virus."
Vast majority of children, they're not at high risk for severe disease.
Dr. Mills says if students do have a health condition and are at high risk, make sure they have an updated vaccine card within the last year and get the newest version of the shot this fall, though it's not required by schools.
Schools are not pushing that as a requirement in any way, shape, or form.
Dr. Mills says right now in the state, there are about 40 people in the hospital with COVID. And since the pandemic began, Maine has seen more than 7,000 people in the hospital due to the virus. Superintendent Langless is hopeful that this school year will see fewer challenges from COVID.
Easy to be excited because of the energy of the kids, but it's even easier to be excited because we don't have some of these barriers we've been facing the last couple of years.
Traffic along Route 3 in Trenton has caused considerable issues for both drivers and those who work in the area. Our Doug Banks went to Trenton to see just how bad the traffic is.
From Ellsworth to Bar Harbor, Route 3 covers over 20 miles. In the middle of that stretch lies Trenton. From Mount Desert Island to Trenton, Maine DOT reports a 2% increase in vehicle volume since before 2020.
Now, that may not sound like a lot, but if the roadway is near its capacity, then even a small single-digit increase might have some impacts on traffic.
Population increases and tourism play a factor as to why so many cars are on the road. Some traffic has been caused by construction, roadwork, and car accidents.
Recently, there's been some incidents and accidents along there, drunk driving, distracted driving.
Traffic has impacted businesses along Route 3 as well. Local owners say some days their restaurants are slammed because so many people want out of their cars. And at times, restaurants are left vacant because some just want to get to their destination as soon as possible.
The bottom line is we got parts of our state that a lot of people want to be in.
Now, what about first responders? Trenton Fire Department had over 150 calls last year to car accidents, 60 so far this year. And in a situation where every second counts, first responders are finding themselves on a road that was not built for this influx of vehicles.
Just waiting for someone to come and help, and then to have that delay, you know, that's tough.
The Trenton Fire Department understands that shoulders on Route 3 are sometimes non-existent. But even when they are in their volunteer trucks on the way to the station, if you see a flashing red light, pulling over,
that's going to put that person either at the scene faster or to the firehouse faster to get an engine to go to the call.
In Trenton, Doug Banks, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Affordable housing could be coming to Bradford, but the plan has triggered some controversy. Our Matthew Duroncic has the story.
Some residents in the town of Bradford are upset upon learning of a property on Middle Road that they heard would become a homeless encampment. However, Bangor Friends of Affordable Housing President Michael Tuller says this is simply not true.
No, we're not trying to move all the homeless out here. Right, we're trying to create a little bit more housing to help people who need it.
Purchasing the property back in July, Tuller says he plans on following a model used in Eugene, Oregon, where Governor Tina Kotek distributed funds to help individuals get proper housing and jobs. A blueprint he says he believes will be effective here in Maine.
That's kind of my vision as I'm moving forward, to create that kind of community where people can help each other and they can find a place where they can be safe, dry, and warm.
Even though Tuller is looking to address a statewide problem, some Bradford residents say this is not the best use of this land.
I don't see it should be happening in this town, and there's no buildings, septic systems, or wells up there on that property. They're just putting people wherever they want that don't need to be, especially on the middle road with the stuff's happened there in the last couple of years.
Arriving on the site, Tuller told us he was in the middle of installing a septic system. This was confirmed by Town Select Board member Julie McCarthy. McCarthy didn't have much to tell us except that this topic will be discussed at the Town Select Board meeting Monday at 6 p.m. Despite what people are saying, Tuller says he's trying to help make a difference for someone who desperately needs it.
I can't solve the problem, but I'm just going to do what I can, try to help.
In Bradford, Matthew Duroncic, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
We should have an update regarding that town meeting tonight in our 10 p.m. news. All right, in other news now, Northern Light Eastern Maine Medical Center kicked off their Champion the Cure Challenge with a two-day fundraiser this weekend, bringing together over 1,000 Mainers who have been impacted by cancer. Our Grace Blanchard has the story.
Champion the Cure Challenge has been around for 14 years, striving to give local cancer patients hope to receive tomorrow's treatments today.
As long as cancer exists, Champion the Cure Challenge is showing up to the fight.
Over the past 2 days, people have been participating in cycling, running, and walking events in an effort to raise funds for the Northern Light Lafayette Cancer Institute in Brewer.
And all of the money raised here stays here, right in this building, giving our amazing clinicians the resources to avail patients to the latest, greatest treatments.
For many, it was also a day full of emotions.
It's an emotional day for a lot of us who've been impacted by cancer in many different ways. And this is a way of us giving back and raising money for such a wonderful cause.
Many put together teams to walk or run in honor of those they lost to cancer.
My late husband, he passed in 2019 from colorectal cancer. His name is Tom. But I have a wonderful group here. Some are my coworkers, some are friends, some are family, and it's been an amazing day.
Since COVID, their fundraising numbers have been lower, but the goal is to get back to raising $1 million a year for cancer care.
You probably know somebody that's been affected by cancer. And so if you have, you understand how devastating the disease is and how much we need resources that stay right here at home.
For more information about how to support the cause, visit our website at foxbangor.com. In Brewer, Grace Blanchard, ABC 7, and Fox 22 News.
A local nonprofit also participated in fundraising efforts this weekend for cancer care patients. The 11th annual Sarah's House benefit yard sale was on Saturday and Sunday. Sarah's House is a nonprofit that provides housing to patients and families that have had to travel 30 miles or more to go to the cancer care center in Brewer. The event is put on each year by the Better Homes and Gardens Masalo Group in Bangor. All the items at the yard sale were donated by community members.
Great way to recycle goods. You know, we're helping the earth, we're helping Sarah's House. It's great. Having this support from the business community and, you know, just everybody in the community is amazing. It's exactly how we continue what we do.
There were no price tags as everything was based on donations. All proceeds collected will be going directly to Sarah's House. For more information about the organization, you can visit our website, foxbangor.com. A yard sale is one of my favorite ways of fundraising, but I love yard sales. Okay, well, the time is now 6:13. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, we'll hear from the town manager of Machias, who reports that an uptick in the town's population has promoted economic growth. But first, let's take another look at that forecast. Partly cloudy today. I know it's already rained a little bit this morning. High of 79 degrees, a muggy one today. Dropping down about 54 tonight, getting colder as the nights go on. That's crazy. Fall is right around the corner. Cloudy overnight and into tomorrow, although we'll see mostly sun and some breeze tomorrow. High of 77.
If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or asbestos-related lung cancer, contact the law offices of Joe Bornstein to learn about your legal rights. Maine has the highest rate of mesothelioma fatalities in the U.S. You may be eligible to receive compensation if you were exposed to asbestos products while working in a shipyard, mill, factory, or construction site. For a free case evaluation, dial 207-CALL-JOE or online at joebornstein.com.
Update your outdoor living space and make the most of your outdoor life with a new deck from Hammond Lumber Company. From wood to low-maintenance composite and PVC decking, Hammond has the materials, knowledge, and experience to help you get everything you need for that perfect new deck. Railing options include wood, composite, aluminum, and the modern look of cable railing. Your Hammond sales rep can answer any questions and will walk you through your options. Get the deck you want, the one you deserve, when you bring your vision to Hammond Lumber Company.
Hello, Eastern Maine. Watch You Bet Your Life weekdays at 10 a.m. here on ABC 7.
A Maine veteran whose career was cut short has found a new purpose.
I mean, this is huge.
I needed a way to continue to serve. And again, I saw the difference that Moxie made for me, and so I wanted to pay it forward to others.
We'll share more about the nonprofit Mission Working Dogs tonight on ABC 7 News at 6.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith. Town leaders say the town of Machias has seen notable growth in recent years. R.A.J. Douglas spoke to the town manager for more on the town's bump in population.
There's a tremendous amount of pride in seeing this resurgence, in being able to drive town line to town line and see so many new things happening.
Machias town manager Bill Kitchen credits the town's growth to a number of sources, ranging from gaining access to federal ARPA funds to contractors building more commercial and residential buildings. President of King Construction, Justin King, has developed two apartment buildings and contracted commercial buildings as a part of K properties, such as Eastport Health Clinic. King is responsible for creating over a dozen apartment units, but he says the lack of housing availability is still a problem.
Our buildings are full months before they're completed. The housing shortage is a real problem here in town, which is why I started building them.
According to Kitchen, Machias has seen the addition of four new eateries, a fuel farm added to the local airport, and a boost in the town's population as more people have decided to work from home.
We are seeing a lot of growth across a lot of metrics.
In Machias, I'm AJ Douglas for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Some good news down east. All right, well, remote workers may start making the commute to a Bucksport library. Our David Ledford has the story.
Buck Memorial Library is one of a handful of public libraries in the state chosen to receive funding to support remote workers. Libraries in 15 Maine counties have been awarded a combined $1.7 million through the Maine Department of Economic and Community Development's Maine Jobs and Recovery Plan. Bucksport Memorial Library Director Lisa Ladd says that their $8,000 portion of that funding will allow them to create an environment where people can get things done.
Laptops that we can loan to people while they're here, noise-canceling headphones, privacy screens, comfortable, comfy chairs. We'll be getting some benches for people to take their laptops outside and conduct their business that way.
Others are hoping that the changes will show the value of the library as a hub for the community.
A lot of people think of libraries as just places to come and get books. Certainly we are that, and we have a wonderful collection. But there are so many other resources here.
Ladd says the additions will benefit more than just remote workers.
We also have a real uptick in students who are taking classes remotely. They're coming in here and doing their schoolwork. This is a way to support them.
Ladd says she plans to implement the changes over the coming months. In the meantime, volunteers say visitors can stop by to learn more about what the library has to offer.
It's just a whole host of resources here. Even if we don't have it, the library is a great starting point for learning where people can access other resources.
In Bucksport, David Ledford, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
All right, the time now is 6:18. After the break, we'll check out the crowds that gathered for the Belfast Harbor Fest over the weekend. Plus, a tornado lifted a car off the ground in Rhode Island on Saturday. We'll have footage of this and more as Good Morning Maine continues.
Hi, this is Jason.
And this is Jessica from Tossie's Checkout.
A family-owned business located in Glenburn.
Inviting you to come experience that welcoming hometown feeling when you're visiting our neck of the woods.
You can always expect tasty treats.
Pizza.
Spirits.
Familiar faces.
And quality gasoline.
With summer approaching and Pushaw Lake nearby,
we look forward to seeing your smiling faces.
Come check us out.
I got rear-ended at a stoplight and needed surgery, and the insurance company tried to give me this tiny little check.
This tiny little check won't even cover my car repairs.
After a car accident, don't take a tiny check from the insurance company. Call the twos.
I said no way to this tiny check. I called the twos, and Lowry & Associates got me $300,000.
I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. Call the twos. We win for you.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
We're on the Christmas storm.
We had just fixed two broken lines. We heard screaming coming from across the road.
I was so scared that I was gonna lose him. He's the apple of my eye.
Nancy said that Kai was choking, and so I gave him a good hard hit in between his shoulder blades and saw something come out of his mouth, so I knew that was a good sign.
If Dana wasn't here, I don't know what I'd done. He just showed up out of the blue, saved his life.
Crowds gathered at the Belfast waterfront on Saturday for the return of a festival that honors the city's history. Our David Ledford brings us a closer look.
It's just an opportunity to, you know, to be on the water, enjoy it, promote Belfast as a sort of an adventure destination.
The 16th annual Harbor Fest has returned to Belfast. The multi-day festival is a free celebration of the city's maritime history and traditions, bringing together a boat-building challenge, food trucks, and an array of children's activities.
Originally, there were a lot of boats were built here, so it really is celebrating the nautical heritage of Belfast. That's where the boat-building challenge comes in. And then we tried to, you know, make it sort of a something for everyone.
The event also features live music, boat tours, and a Pinewood Derby race.
It's the Showmobile.
Visitors from near and far came out for their favorite activities.
The music is definitely great.
Ice cream's awesome. Boat building's really interesting.
The hoops.
I've been to all of it, and I like all of it.
The festival raises money for the Belfast Rotary Club, which hosts the event. And representatives say the money raised during the celebration will go right back into the community.
We give away about $80,000 a year in scholarships, both to colleges, but also to technical schools. We also give away, you know, to food pantries. You know, we raise money for clothing closets and a lot of little community organizations.
With hundreds taking part in the event, some who came out say the Harbor Fest helps to highlight the people of Belfast.
People are really friendly.
Venues like this, it's just awesome. It brings people in from all over.
Community kind of stuff is really great.
The event will wrap up with boat racing and a lobster gala Sunday. In Belfast, David Ledford, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
They had a good day for it. Looks nice. All right, the time now is 6:22. Time to get a full look at that forecast with meteorologist Evan Biggs.
All righty, Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. All righty, this morning, a few showers, even a rumble of thunder developing after this morning, tracking from the west going toward the east, along a little wave of energy right about in here. This will mainly move through during the morning period today, along with the clouds. We'll get some sunshine rolling during the afternoon period. The bigger picture looks like this. We have a little cold front moving through right now, so just enough energy to get some showers and a rumble of thunder this morning. We'll get some sunshine going, mixing in with the clouds during the afternoon period. But meanwhile, though, look out toward the west right now. Hopefully many of you have been paying attention to this. Look at this. Tropical Storm Hillary still going in parts of California right now with a lot of rainfall that's been taking place with this as well. The last update showing 40 mile per hour winds sustained overall, moving towards the north-northwest at 28 miles per hour. Wind's not the big issue with this one. It's a lot of rain that continues to move through and will be causing some issues for parts of California. It'll track to the north, continuing to weaken, becoming extratropical, though, with 35 mile per hour winds by later on this morning, and then we'll continue to see things tracking off towards the north after that. So futurecast moving forward for today, back here at home, a partly cloudy sky this afternoon as we get the rain showers and rumbles of thunder out of here. More clouds approach later on tonight, but notice after midnight, the clouds get out of here, so we'll have a lot of sunshine to greet us for your Tuesday and beyond. Oh, not a lot of clouds, maybe a few during the afternoon period, but then becoming mostly clear as we head towards Tuesday night and looking pretty good as we head towards Wednesday. Our average high temperature being 79 degrees. We'll do just about that today, maybe a few degrees below. Maybe if you could also touch the lower 80s overall. Depends on how much sunshine we get, but we'll do upper 70s also Tuesday to Wednesday, middle 70s Thursday, and then cooling off a bit Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, upper 60s to lower 70s for those high temperatures. Let's talk about the dew points. Those are finally starting to go down as well, though. We'll have a little bit in the 60s this morning, but then once we get towards Tuesday and the next few days, remaining in the 50s, but Friday and Saturday possibly back into the lower 60s. So that forecast for today, upper 70s, maybe a few lower 80s. Some of you could be also be a little bit cooler than 79 degrees. Some morning showers and a rumble of thunder, but then becoming partly cloudy with that north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. By tonight, partly cloudy. We'll have lows in the middle 50s. That north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. For tomorrow, upper 70s, mostly sunny, breezy out there too. North wind getting up to about 20 miles per hour. Scott's Recreation extended forecast. So lots of sunshine again for your Wednesday with highs in the upper 70s. Middle 70s for your Thursday with a partly cloudy sky. And showers are back on Friday. Highs in the low 70s.
Established in 1925, Bangor Floral has been a premier provider of beautiful floral arrangements and thoughtful gifts for almost 100 years. Whatever the occasion, our premium collection of colorful blooms, blossoming plants, and gift baskets have warmed hearts for generations. We strongly support the Buy Local movement, purchasing directly from local farms and growers, and we are committed to the preservation of our environment. Bangor Floral, located at 332 Harlow Street. Stop in today to experience a flower shop like no other.
Lumber is locally owned and has been serving the Pecos region for more than 50 years. See them for all your projects, big or small. Customer service is their number one priority. And with a full line of lumber and hardware items, they can also deliver to your job site. Harris Lumber, Milo.
It was like 8 o'clock, and Rick's not home yet. I called his phone, and there was no answer. My front doorbell rings. I knew the minute I heard the doorbell what was on the other side. They knew that Rick was driving 8 miles an hour and the brakes were engaged and the person that rear-ended him just wasn't paying attention. Unless you're looking straight ahead, everything else you do is distracted driving. If this could help one family, time well spent. Nobody should have that knob in the door.
There's one number you need to know. It's called Joe.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith. Well, Rhode Islanders are cleaning up after at least one tornado in the area not only damaged some homes, buildings, and businesses, but even lifted up a car on the highway. The firefighters rushed to help the driver on Interstate 295 in Rhode Island, who was found unharmed. The severe storms made for dangerous driving conditions across New England, with a few thousand power outages reported. Johnston and Scituate were some of the hardest hit communities. That's scary. All right, we turn now to the dramatic new video from the early hours of the devastating fires in Maui, just as President Biden prepares to visit today. ABC's Andrew Dimbert has the latest.
This morning, new videos of the wildfires on Maui, showing what firefighters faced as they arrived to the historic town of Lahaina, engulfed by the fire. At one point, flames surround a fire engine before firefighters are able to escape. In his first national interview since the fires, Maui's fire chief getting emotional.
The firefighters are hurting. This is their community. This is their home. These are their people. Nobody in our department is unaffected by this.
We care about our firefighters first and our community as well. And if they can't go to work in a healthy way, then it's difficult for them to serve.
Officials say 85% of the destroyed area on Maui has now been searched. President Biden will see the devastation firsthand today, meeting with survivors.
Hear their stories and provide a sense of hope and assurance that the federal government is going to be with them as he has directed, and we will continue to bring in resources to support the requests of the governor and the needs as they go through their recovery process.
Local residents have been critical of the federal response, including the $700 relief checks announced by FEMA, some saying that's not nearly enough to begin rebuilding their lives. There is hope and resilience amid the rubble. Worshippers still gathered for Sunday service at a coffee house 23 miles away from their now destroyed church. And the area's famed 150-year-old banyan tree is still standing and, according to experts, still alive, undergoing life-saving treatment.
We checked underneath the bark of all the lower trunks on the tree, and we found that there's still live tissue. We didn't see any major charring or scarring of the tree.
FEMA says it's distributed nearly $4 million so far to about 1,600 Maui residents. Andrew Dimbert, ABC News, New York.
Canada's wildfire devastation continues and hits upper regions and incinerates one town. Canadian officials say a significant number of structures have been burned down in the Northwest Territories of Canada. Fires burned through the hamlet of Enterprise, forcing residents to evacuate. No deaths were reported, though, from the fires in the community. Canada has been hit by a record number of fires this year, including recent ones that choked up the upper Midwest and Northeast early this summer, as we know, with hazy orange smoke. About 5,700 fires have burned more than 53,000 square miles of land, according to Canadian officials. Turning now to the latest on Tropical Storm Hillary, now bearing down across Southern California. Flash flood and high wind warnings have been called across the region. It's unprecedented. Some desert areas have reportedly received nearly 1 inch of rain in an hour. And now Hillary is forecast to bring soaking rains to parts of Nevada. ABC's Justin Finch is following the latest from Washington.
This morning, high alert from Southern California to Nevada as Hillary churns north, packing gusting winds and heavy rains. More than 42 million Americans facing tropical storm warnings. California's governor declaring a state of emergency as the mayor of Los Angeles warns of an unprecedented weather event.
Stay safe, stay informed, and stay home. The worst of the rains is potentially left to come.
In Southern California, rain-saturated streets are making for treacherous driving conditions, leading to crashes. In Thousand Palms, California, streets unpassable.
We are flooded.
Multiple flash flood warnings in effect. Ahead of the storm, a rush to stock up on supplies and fill sandbags.
Hoping for the best, but preparing for the worst.
Amid the hammering storm, these swaying lights signaling a 5.1 magnitude earthquake in Los Angeles.
Our studio is shaking right now, so not only are we dealing with a tropical storm, but it appears we're now dealing with an earthquake.
This is the first time we've had a magnitude 5 since 1932 in exactly this location.
Crews have stacked large sand berms along the shorelines to shield against powerful waves.
This is what we look for.
Kite boarders at San Diego's Pacific Beach taking advantage of Hillary's high winds as it moved north after making landfall in Baja California, Mexico, and leaving severe flooding behind. So far, no reports of damage or injuries from that earthquake, which experts say is unrelated to the storm. President Biden says he's deployed federal resources to assist California and Nevada as needed, as forecasters warn of residual storm impacts, including mudslides and tornadoes. Justin Finch, ABC News, Washington.
All right, coming up on the second half of our newscast, an Old Town police deputy braved a bad smell and did a good deed over the weekend. We'll check out the body cam footage as Good Morning Maine continues.
These days you can buy a new mattress anywhere. However, getting the right mattress at the right price will keep you up at night. When you're ready for a new mattress, come to Dorsey's. We've delivered more mattresses to this area than any other retailer. With over 48 years of experience, the largest in-stock selection, plus our 30-night sleep guarantee, we've got the right mattress for you at a great price. Dorsey Furniture, Route 1A, Holden. Sleep well, my friends.
Here we are at Rennie's in Wells on Route 1. Let's go see some people. Come on.
We need some swimsuit and some fun stuff for the kids to do and enjoy the beach.
What game did you get?
Candyland.
That's a good one.
Oh, that is a good one.
That's a fun game.
Awesome store, down to earth. You know, I love it. It's just a fantastic. It's an adventure coming here all the time. You know, it's like a treasure hunt, you know?
No,
that's a slogan, but I mean, that's what it's about, you know? Granny's the main
adventure. Wow. Like the kids, the bills are getting bigger every month.
I know. From childcare to electric, I don't know how we're going to do it. We need to cut. Let's pay this one next month.
Not sure we can. We already cut everything. And now electricity prices are going up.
What are we going to do? We need help.
I heard that the PUC's website has information about financial assistance and conservation programs.
We've never asked for help before.
I know.
But this year, things are different.
When the acres add up, so does the work. The Kubota LO2 series is ready for it. Part of the number one rated tractor brand for durability and owner experience, it features powerful, dependable Kubota diesel engines, performance matched attachments, and the versatility to get the job done right.
Available at Doors Equipment, 1468 Outer Hammond Street, Bangor.
You're watching ABC7 Bangor.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. Today is Monday, August 21st, 2023, and today is National Senior Citizens Day. Seniors are often active in our communities, continuing to have a strong presence in the workforce, whether that be paid positions or much-needed volunteer work. Regardless, though, if they're working or retired, today is a day meant to honor the seniors in our lives and recognize their accomplishments and contributions. And if you are a senior, feel free to demand a bit more respect today. Okay, now for some history. On this day in 1897, the first Oldsmobile automobile was manufactured by the Olds Motor Vehicle Company in Lansing, Michigan. In 1911, the Mona Lisa painting was stolen from the Louvre. It was recovered just 2 years later and returned to the museum. In 1942, decades later, Walt Disney's animated movie Bambi was released to crowds for the first time. The film has been based on the book by Felix Salten. I kind of forget that because generations of people grew up watching that movie, and it oftentimes came decades before they were born. It's so cool. I watched it as a kid too. And in 1969, the first Gap clothing store opened up in San Francisco. It's been a while since Bangor has had a Gap. I think the closest one must be in Augusta or Freeport or something, which is a bummer. I like it. Okay, lastly now, in 2015, a message in a bottle was found after 108 years on the shores of Amrum, Germany. It had been put in the sea by a marine biologist all those years before. Kind of makes me want to do that too. I did one as a kid. I wonder if anybody ever found it. For birthdays today, we have retired Jamaican sprinter Usain Bolt. He's 37 today. I need to do some research and find out if that was his name before he started training or if he changed his name. Either way, very cool. He has been considered the greatest sprinter of all time. American comedian and musician Bo Burnham is 33 today. And Grammy Award-winning American country singer Kacey Musgraves is 35 today. A lot of talent today. Okay, moving on now. Let's check in with Devin Biggs. It's kind of a cloudy Monday morning. I know when I came in quite early this morning, it poured for about 10 minutes. It got it out of its system, though, and it seems like it's been over with. So let's check in with Devin Biggs to see what that rain is going to do.
Alrighty, Emma, thank you very much. Happy Monday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices. With locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. Alright, let's get into things this morning. Not too bad as we do move forward. There are a few showers that are developing, even a few rumbles of thunder that have been developing earlier this morning as well. We do have a few showers that will be common as well, and a few rumbles of thunder, mainly during the morning period. As for the afternoon, we will be under a partly cloudy sky over. Overall, as we do zoom things down and give you the bigger picture, just some clouds that are currently moving through, along with a few showers and a rumble of thunder as well. Again, this afternoon, a lot of this will start to taper off as some sunshine will start to peek out. Future cast for today reflecting now the partly cloudy sky for us today. More clouds later on tonight, but after midnight, the clouds get out of here. We'll have a lot of sunshine to start things off for you Tuesday. The winds won't be a huge deal, though. They'll be switching around a bit, but only at around 5 to 10 miles per hour overall. They'll be a little bit more on the gusty side tomorrow with sustained winds at around 10 miles per hour. per hour or more. Gusty winds up to 20 miles per hour cannot be ruled out either. So as for today, upper 70s, maybe some lower 80s if you're lucky. Some morning showers and a rumble of thunder. Partly cloudy with that north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. That partly cloudy sky will be during the afternoon period. Middle 50s for tonight with a partly cloudy sky. That north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Our only forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period showing a mostly cloudy sky with a few morning showers possible. Temperatures in the 70s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up. Emma?
Thank you, Devin. Well, what's black and white and stuck in the Dunkin' drive-thru? Well, according to the body cam footage from the Old Town Police Department, the answer is a skunk. A few weeks ago, Officer Hilton of Old Town Police encountered a skunk with two Dunkin' cups stuck on its head. Thanks to his quick footwork, lightning reflexes, Hilton was able to avoid the skunk's business and was able to remove the cup, both cups actually, from the critter's noggin. Okay, whoever wrote this really had fun with it. According to the Old Town Police Department's Facebook page, where the video was released, Hilton had never seen a skunk before moving to Maine in April. Not too bad for an out-of-stater. Oh, look at it running away. Oh, good deed done for the week, I'd say. Wow. Okay. I had been waiting to see that video all morning. I'm excited. Okay, still to come here this morning, Ryan Sudol will have the latest with sports. Don't go away.
With AAA Insurance, by bundling our home and auto policies, we saved over $450.
And we were shocked at the savings.
When we switched to AAA Auto Insurance and bundled our policies, we were able to save over $400 every year.
Switch to AAA Insurance today, and you could save an average of $483 on auto insurance. Compare that to State Farm, GEICO, even Allstate. Call now for your free AAA full picture quote to find out how much you could save.
Well, my passion is hang gliding. I've been doing it for over 30 years, and it's like flying. I mean, it's like everything you always dreamed about. AAA Insurance helps us save more.
And do more.
The savings from AAA Insurance has allowed me to pursue my passion of making jewelry. It's great to have a little bit of extra cash to do something that you love.
To find out how much you could save by switching to AAA Insurance, call 866-460-1310 for your free AAA full picture quote today. You'll be glad you did.
This fall, you'll vote on a costly electric scheme. It's called Pine Tree Power. And here are the facts. It will cost Mainers $13.5 billion. An independent study says it will increase electric bills. And this scheme is so poorly written, Pine Tree Power isn't required to have an operations plan when it takes over. No plan to keep the lights on. That's a bad idea. Vote no on question 3.
Wood, composite, or PVC, with options that include the modern look of cable railing. Your perfect new deck begins when you bring your vision to Hammond Lumber Company.
Hey everybody, Ryan Sudol here. Thank you so much for joining us. A yearly tradition made its way back to Bangor on Saturday, the 15th annual Wayne's Wiffle for a Wish tournament. A full day full of great fun for an even greater cause.
This day is the best of the summer.
Every third Saturday in August since 2009, teams from everywhere come to the Union Street Complex in Bangor for the Wayne's Wiffle for a Wish Wiffle Ball Tournament.
Everybody's out here having fun and everybody's laughing, just playing some wiffle ball. I mean, who doesn't like wiffle ball?
And who doesn't like charity? The tournament benefits the Make-A-Wish Foundation of Maine. Wayne Harvey decided to start the tournament after frequenting hospitals with his then infant daughter.
Each time we'd have these procedures, she got to come home at night. But we saw a lot of kids that weren't going to have a happy ending and come home.
So Wiffle for a Wish was born, raising $2,000 its first year with 15 teams. Saturday, there were 36 teams with an expected total of around $20,000.
It's community events like this that make Make-A-Wish possible. And each year, it's bigger and bigger and bigger.
The tournament has raised over $160,000, enough to fund nearly 30 wishes for Maine children facing life-threatening illnesses. like Hamden's Adrian Ellingwood, a cancer survivor whose wish came true when he went to the MLS All-Star Game last month.
It was just amazing. It was more than I could have ever asked for.
But when you go through a traumatic experience like this, you forget how to have joy. We experienced a lot of joy at the Make-A-Wish.
Yep.
With that, the tournament is all in good fun for the competitors. But don't let that fool you.
Oh no, they're serious. We start getting in the middle of the afternoon, we get closer to playoffs. Now they're really competitive. Now we're playing for tournament titles.
And don't let how simple it may look fool you either. Even some top local baseball stars have trouble with the curve.
We were just telling each other the whole time, just throw a strike, but it's easier said than done. It was a good time. I mean, we got our butts handed to us, but it was definitely something that we'll come back to next year.
Even though the tournament may bear his name, Wayne knows that it's the help from the community that ensures there always is a next year.
If it wasn't for my wife, my kids, friends, family, people who have become friends and family through this, that's really what makes this work. The people here are wonderful to kind of give back and be part of this.
I promised her I would get her into the story, and I did. If you want to make a donation to Make-A-Wish Maine, go to wish.org/Maine. Okay, now let's move to the Little League World Series. Gray New Gloucester and Raymond playing their second game down in Williamsport Saturday against Pennsylvania. This one is win or go home. Top first, bases loaded. PA's Trevor Skowronek lines this one into right field. Grant Branson trouble with it. Nate Selesky and Austin Crowley score. It's 2-0 Pennsylvania. Bottom first, Maine's Gage Ryu lines one into left. Cole Carroll can't handle it. Ryu churning for third and gets there safely. He'd later score on an errant pickoff attempt, so it's 3-1. Bottom four, 3-2 now. Runners on first and second. Mason Emergen lines one to center. Ryu coming home. The throw is late, and we are tied up at three. Finally, top six. Selesky up for Pennsylvania. Men on second and third. Rips it into left. It gets down. Carroll comes around to score to give PA the 4-3 lead, and that is the difference maker. PA goes on to win 5-3. Maine's run ends here, but what a run it was. And once again, a big congratulations to GNG and Raymond for making us all proud. Finally, some more baseball. A national sensation invaded the Pine Tree State Friday and Saturday as the Savannah Bananas brought their brand of baseball, or banana ball, to Portland. Anna Kuhn has that story.
Rival teams faced off in front of a sold-out crowd at Hadlock Field tonight, but the players here did a lot more than just play ball.
And they're just entertainers. That's fun. It's like the Harlem Globetrotters of baseball.
Palmer worked almost every Sea Dogs game this season, but he said he's never seen anything quite like this.
Oh, this is very different. This is it's amazing. They're 10 special rules they have.
Rules like no walks or bunts, and if a fan catches a ball, that's an out. Which mostly means you don't have to be a baseball fan to enjoy these innings.
I wish every baseball game was like that. I'd go to more baseball games.
The team has 3 million followers on TikTok and is nationally famous for umpires and coaches dancing on the field, their banana pep band, and the only baseball player in the world that plays on stilts.
In 2021, I went to baseball tryouts with the Bananas, and in the tryout description said, bring your weirdest talents. So I told him I could walk on stilts, and Jesse asked me if I could hit a baseball. So I told him, heck yeah, I can. And I've been barreling balls 10 foot in the air ever since.
Players say there's nothing quite like this experience.
My opinion, better than baseball. Just the fan interaction, making kids' days. In regular baseball, you don't really get to interact with fans that much. And it's nice to see a smile on their face.
And fans in Portland were definitely smiling, thrilled to have this team show up in their city.
Hopefully they come back again year after year.
I love those guys. That's all the time we have for sports. I'm Ryan Sudol. We'll be back right after the break.
The first ever Mazda CX-50, purpose-built for the outdoors. With our most advanced driving technology for responsive, consistent performance on-road and off that entices you to go further more often.
Find your new Mazda today at Varney Mazda, 260 Hogan Road in Bangor, and discover what Varney Value is all about.
Stop waiting.
Start living your life without knee or hip pain. Connect with a Northern Light orthopedist and get back out there. Northern Light Eastern Maine Medical Center. How are you?
If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or asbestos-related lung cancer, contact the law offices of Joe Bornstein to learn about your legal rights. Maine has the highest rate of mesothelioma fatalities in the U.S. You may be eligible to receive compensation if you were exposed to asbestos products while working in a shipyard, mill, factory, or construction site. For a free case evaluation, dial 207-CALL-JOE or online at joebornstein.com.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. Well, residents and immigrants in the greater Portland area laced up their soccer cleats Sunday for a soccer tournament. Asia Reed spoke with players and an organizer on how soccer is bringing this community together.
The purpose of this is to bring people together.
Dozens of folks showed out at Fitzpatrick Stadium, all here for two things: soccer and a sense of community.
We thought about this, we talked about this, and we made it happen, you know?
Machu Atete says most of these soccer players moved to Maine from Congo, and a few players are born and raised right here in Maine. Sunday's games were sponsored by the Maine Immigrants' Rights Coalition. Players say there is an end goal for this tournament.
We're trying to do this thing for our young kids and our young brothers to give them an opportunity, a chance to be seen.
The soccer tournament is also to keep these new Mainers busy and develop life skills that go with them off the field.
We want them to play soccer, to be focused, and because in soccer you find some discipline. So that's all about.
Sunday's event isn't just for soccer players. Music and dancing also helped bring these folks together. One of the organizers, Emmanuel Sungu Bele, says this is more than just a soccer game.
As you know, soccer is a unifying factor. Soccer goes across languages, politics, and all our differences, for the love of the sport.
Players say this tournament is the first of its kind, but it's just the beginning.
Trying to do this for the future generation, especially for immigrants, because we want to keep them busy.
It's to help, the new immigrants coming into the state of Maine, with their needs that they may have, questions that they may have, and to give them the support that they need to settle in.
Players say they want to help create a sense of community.
We can do something better for immigrants and, let's say, for Mainers.
That's awesome. Love to see it. Okay, now here's meteorologist Evan Biggs with our full weather forecast.
Alrighty, Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. Alrighty, this morning, a few showers, even a rumble of thunder developing after this morning, tracking from the west going toward the east, along a little wave of energy right about in here. This will mainly move through during the morning period today, along with the clouds. We'll get some sunshine rolling during the afternoon period. The bigger picture looks like this. We have a little cold front moving through right now, so just enough energy to get some showers and a rumble of thunder this morning. We'll get some sunshine going, mixing in with the clouds during the afternoon period. But meanwhile, though, look out toward the west right now. Hopefully many of you have been paying attention to this. Look at this. Tropical Storm Hillary still going in parts of California right now with a lot of rainfall that's been taking place with this as well. The last update showing 40 mile per hour winds sustained overall, moving towards the north-northwest at 28 miles per hour. Wind's not the big issue with this one. It's a lot of rain that continues to move through and will be causing some issues for parts of California. It'll track to the north, continuing to weaken, becoming extra tropical, though, with 35 mile per hour winds by later on this morning, and then we'll continue to see things tracking off towards the north after that. So futurecast moving forward for today, back here at home, a partly cloudy sky this afternoon as we get the rain showers and rumbles of thunder out of here. More clouds approach later on tonight, but notice after midnight, the clouds get out of here, so we'll have a lot of sunshine to greet us for your Tuesday and beyond. Oh, not a lot of clouds, maybe a few during the afternoon period, but then becoming mostly clear as we head towards Tuesday night and looking pretty good as we head towards Wednesday. Our average high temperature being 79 degrees. We'll do just about that today, maybe a few degrees below. Maybe if you could also touch the lower 80s overall. Depends on how much sunshine we get, but we'll do upper 70s also Tuesday to Wednesday, middle 70s Thursday. And then cooling off a bit Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, upper 60s to lower 70s for those high temperatures. Let's talk about the dew points. Those are finally starting to go down as well, though. We'll have a little bit in the 60s this morning, but then once we get towards Tuesday and the next few days, remaining in the 50s, but Friday and Saturday possibly back into the lower 60s. So that forecast for today, upper 70s, maybe a few lower 80s. Some of you could be also be a little bit cooler than 79 degrees. Some morning showers and a rumble of thunder, but then becoming partly cloudy with that north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. By tonight, partly cloudy. We'll have lows in the middle 50s. That north wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. For tomorrow, upper 70s, mostly sunny, breezy out there too. North wind getting up to about 20 miles per hour. Scott's Recreation extended forecast. So lots of sunshine again for your Wednesday with highs in the upper 70s. Middle 70s for your Thursday with a partly cloudy sky. And showers are back on Friday. Highs in the low 70s.
General Rental Center has been serving Central Maine for more than 30 years with an extensive inventory, including mini track loaders with attachments, full-size track skid steer, track loader and backhoe, wheel loader with attachments, a 50-foot towable aerial lift, and a 45-foot self-propelled four-wheel drive lift. If you can't find it on our website, we can find it for you. Call for multi-day and weekend special rates. Just minutes from exit 157 in Newport, Foggy's Pub is now open, serving delicious food in a casual, fun atmosphere. Relax inside or out on the deck. Pair it up with a handcrafted cocktail or choose from 20 cold brews on tap. Visit Foggy's Pub at Fogbrook Resort.
Let your creativity run free in the Creative Arts Center, where we offer fun and affordable activities for all ages. Birthday parties, pottery wheel classes, painting lessons, or just for the fun of it. Get fired up for glazing projects as well as acrylics. We offer a wide selection of ceramic products for you to choose from, and we have thousands of pieces ready to paint. We are a Paragon Kiln dealer and a Laguna Clay distributor. Stop by the Creative Arts Center today, located just off the Joshua Chamberlain Bridge in Brewer. The Creative Arts Center, where your only limitation is your imagination.
It's great buy time at Bob's Small Engine Sales and Service in Bucksport. Now through this August 31st, you can get rebates of up to $1,000 on 2022 CFMoto C-Force off-road ATVs, U-Force utility side-by-sides, and Z-Force side-by-side trail and HO Sport models. These inflation-busting rebates of up to $1,000 are only good through this August 31st. Don't wait. See these great buys now at Bob's Small Engine Sales and Service, Route 15, 474 River Road in Bucksport.
I am in love with three guys. Now I am reconsidering everything.
I don't want to leave here and regret my decision.
Can't breathe, I really can't, and I'm a panic attack.
Do the generations operate differently in how they handle finances, especially in a high-tech era? I mean, personally, I'd say they do. A new Finance Buzz survey, though, shows generational gaps in handling money, with older generations using more traditional means and younger ones using more high-tech-oriented means. Some findings show the differences, such as half of adult Gen Zers saying they have never written a check. Baby boomers are the least likely to use mobile payment apps like Venmo or Cash App, as well as online banks or investing apps. While Gen Zers were least likely to know about credit scores, IRA, and 401k differences. The survey also found a third of millennials think college education is the key driver of making good money. Only a third. Okay, that's fair. That makes sense. All sorts of differences there. Okay, well, it looks like we're about out of time. If you missed anything, please head to foxbangor.com. We will continue broadcasting on Fox 22 for our second hour of Good Morning Maine, but Good Morning America is next on ABC7. We hope you have a great day.